I'm Blake Childress, and I'm That One Filmmaker.
And welcome back to Just Saw, the show where I review recent movies in a shorter format. Today we're going to be reviewing the film Mank, which is on Netflix.
Mank, it's Orson Welles. Ready and willing
to hunt the great white whale?
Just call me Ahab.
Mank is the newest film from director David Fincher, who is seriously one of my favorite directors. With films like Gone Girl, Zodiac, and The Social Network, Fincher has proven how talented he is at making psychological portraits of characters, which I'm a sucker for anything psychological. But with his newest film Mank, it seems he's, in a way, taking a break from his usual shtick of thriller films, which I understand. Sometimes taking a break from what you're known for can spawn new and innovative ideas, so I was excited to see what Mank would bring to the dry 2020 film market. Mank itself is a biographical film about Herman Mankiewicz, who was one of the co-writers on the film Citizen Kane, which is usually considered the best film of all time. I mean, just to get it out of the way, personally, I don't think Citizen Kane is that amazing. I mean, it's a decent movie that was definitely ahead of its time with how it was shot and how its actual story was told. And plus, Citizen Kane established the importance of studios letting writers and directors craft their own unique visions. A lot of people call it overrated, which, I mean, I don't really agree with either. It's more just a movie that has been analyzed and broken down so much that I really just don't have much to add at all. But the movie itself isn't really what's important. The film itself is all about Herman Mankiewicz, his social and career life leading up to writing Citizen Kane, and his desire to be given credit for the screenplay after he had already signed an uncredited agreement. So now that we've got all that out of the way, the question remains, how did this film turn out? Well, honestly, it's not that great. When I first watched it, I kind of told myself, wow, that was good, over and over and over again, because I wanted it to be my favorite film of 2020. And I mean, the story behind Herman Mankiewicz is so interesting, and I tried convincing myself it was great, but I really just can't. One of the film's biggest problems, in my opinion, is that there never seems to be a so what or a call to action within the film's ending. Like, let's say this movie is a $30 million essay by David Fincher. Fincher basically tells you about Mankiewicz, who he was, and his perspective towards the writing of Citizen Kane, and his relationship with William Randolph Hearst, who Citizen Kane was based on. But after he gives us all this information, he just ends it with Mank winning an Oscar and text that says, "Lol, he fucking died." Like, what the hell was the point in telling me all of that information if you aren't trying to say anything about it? I mean, seriously, I have no idea what is to be said about this movie, apart from how corrupt the Hollywood system of the 30s was. I mean, here's the thing. This movie is probably made for people who know about Orson Welles and Citizen Kane, but know nothing about Mankiewicz. Which, I mean, the movie is definitely good at laying out everything you need to know. But, I mean, that's really all it offers. It has the same effect as a fucking Wikipedia page, which for a David Fincher film is pretty bad. Let's compare it to one of his other films, The Social Network. Both films are biographies towards important individuals. What separates these two movies is that The Social Network gives you information in a way that is entertaining to watch.
I believe I deserve some recognition from this board.
I'm sorry?
Yes.
I don't understand.
Which part?
And I can tell, Mank tries to do exactly what The Social Network did, but it just feels flat and boring.
Aw, nerds.
What's nerds?
Nerds is Brooklynese for nuts.
Jeepers.
Another problem with the film comes from its acting, which I honestly can't tell if Fincher intentionally had it feel flat as a celebration of flat acting from the past. But I mean, hell, look at Citizen Kane. Most of the performances of the movie are great even to this day.
Read about you in the papers.
There's only one person in the world to decide what I'm going to do, and that's me.
I'm no cheap, crooked politician trying to save himself from the consequences of his crimes. Geddes! I'm going to send you to Sing Sing! Sing Sing, Geddes!
But in Mank, most characters just feel emotionless and deadpan.
What is it the writer says? Tell the story you know.
I hear you're hunting dangerous game.
God bless William Randolph Hearst.
I mean, not sure if this is like a perspective-based thing where Mank sees everyone around him as flat and boring, but I mean, even Gary Oldman doesn't feel like he was even trying.
All in one film. That's director-proof.
The dialogue also did feel somewhat theatrical and less realistic, which personally I think fits since Mank probably sees the world as a screenplay, so everyone around him speaks like how he does.
What makes me cry? Emotion. Where do I feel emotion? Here, here, and here.
But I mean, if I was given the choice between wooden dialogue or good dialogue, I'll choose good any day of the week. The only thing I can honestly say I liked about the movie is its visuals and sound design. The actual look of 1940s Hollywood and the echoed sound that's meant to mimic audio quality of the time, I mean, it kind of reminds me of a more polished and bigger budget version of what Robert Eggers did with The Lighthouse, which is pretty awesome. What's funny is, I see a lot of parallels with this film and Tenet, a film created by a great director that seems to have passion put into it, but it just doesn't live up to their past projects. David, I'm glad you got to make the film your father wrote, but that still doesn't excuse some of the obvious mistakes seen here. I give Mank a 5 out of 10.
Well, now that I've finished randomly reviewing a movie, I can go back to doing what I do best. Gun. Why do I own this? Thank you guys so much for watching this new video. Hope you enjoyed. And I've got a few more videos planned out for the end of That One Filmmaker Season 4. Now I'm gonna go eat a pizza. Bye.
I'm gonna try and get this lip shot right. Swear to God, fuck this shit.
That was a bit weird. Pulling up on the glizzy. Oh, fuck. Oh, I stubbed my... It's not even a fake reaction. I just stubbed my... I popped my bone. Ow, fuck.